guys. New Kent Skeeter review time. Let's do it. 16 miles an hour. Ooh. And let's do the Skeeter review. I'll take off back here in the woods. I just stole this from Paul. He walked away. I took off with this thing. Let's do a Skeeter review. 535D. A little review on the Skeeter we got. This 545D we got a little while back. Do a little walk around on this girl. She has 35.5 tires on it. We went with that instead of a 30.5. Works way better for us than the smaller tires. And the one nice change on these new ones is the blade. If you got an old Cat Skeeter, even the C series or the B series, right here is a big problem. And they fixed that finally. And they put a pin through there. So you don't have to worry about ever pulling your blade off. Ripping your bolts out and pulling your blade off. They fixed it on these new ones. Your cooling fans are back there. All your coolers. Up here, it's just a flat shield. Works really good for us, because when we're pushing bark off that foil chipper, you're constantly pushing bark, and that's why it's a little tore up. You're constantly getting bark up in there, and that way it's not getting into your radiator and all those fines, and that little bit of dust getting in there. This does have the DEF, all that goes in here, and they have us a new tank coming for this. That's what they figured might be the problem with our DEF. On a previous video, I made a video there, some issues we're having. So they're gonna send us a new tank, and once that gets put in here, I'll make another video. But that's what the inside of the motor looks like. Easy to service, guys. Both your fuel filters, your oil filter right here. Boom, boom, boom. And your oil filter right here, easy to drain. Just pop that bottom cover off down there, and like I said, it's, man, you can change the oil in this thing in 15 minutes, and your fuel filters and your air filters. So your air filters are up in here, and that's real simple. So yeah, there's your blade again. They a little better without the sun. That's what they did there. And that's like an old John Deere. Works way better. There's your fans. When this thing runs, there's some other videos they got on there. All you can hear is the fans. You can't hear the exhaust out the motor. This is one of the quietest Skeeters I've ever seen run. You'll hear the wood, you'll hear it skidding out there. You'll hear the wood breaking and tree snapping, but you won't hear this thing run. I mean, it'll sneak right up on you. Real quiet, nice machine. Works great. The winch, we've had a couple problems with that. Cats pulled it right off and fixed it for us, no problems. Just a little itty bitty leak. Hydraulic leak off it. That's the only problem. It's got the valve bank, the big valve bank right here. And the older Deeres and stuff, they're right underneath here, which is kind of a hassle. But you can see how they got everything kind of streamlined here. And a few hoses here. Works really nice. And there's your valve bank back there. You pop the covers off, you can get in there. That's also where your reversing alarm is. We got in there and unplugged that, so that drove us nuts. But as you can tell, the center pins are all real nice, heavy-duty center pins, easy to get at. Drive shaft is huge. That's one thing nice about these two. Everything's heavy-duty when it comes to your drivetrain, your axles. They're all serious about that. So good skid plates underneath it, real simple. This Skeeter's been pretty good for us. Here's the grapple back here. Some people whine about that. This style grapple, this size for us, has been perfect. Once again, look at another video. I made a video of, I think it's called You Want a Skid or something. So You Want a Skid. But some people complain about the way this grabs because it's kind of different angled. But this works great. It'll get a bunch of wood in it. because once you get used to it, it works really good for us. But no complaints there on the grapple. We wanted a bigger grapple, the next size bigger, but they wouldn't put it on there for us unless we went to a 545, because the axles get bigger on the 545 and 555, and they wouldn't put a bigger grapple on a smaller skidder. So we tried, they wouldn't do it. They want us to jump up to a 545, but we didn't. We stayed with the 535. This has surprisingly plenty enough power to do what we do. Yeah, it works really good for us. So we'll jump up. The thing about this is I'll give this, there is bolts all over this thing. And it's not like the some other stuff where you pull a couple pins and stuff comes popping off. This thing is covered in bolts. And we got a little battery-powered 3/4-inch impact, and that works great for this. Because if you ever get into any of the panels, like your transmission fills underneath here, and your transmission filter is right here. So to get to that, you gotta take this off and this off, because it kind of runs down, and there's bolts up underneath there. A lot of bolts, but once you get used to it, you're fine. The cabs tilt on these. Our 545C, it doesn't. There's just a hole in the floor, you pull a panel out. They switched it on these to a roll cab. Once again, a lot better. I'll jump up in here. This is the interior. Pretty simple cat interior. Quarter steer, it only turns that far. Real touchy. That's not the funnest thing in the world for the steering, but I'm not that used to it. But if you get used to it, you put a few thousand hours on it, you're good to go. But see how it's a front pretty good. It's got a long front end on it, but that ain't no big deal. What's nice about this is that's just your exhaust coming out there. Heavy duty. But yeah. And like your other cats, it's got your gear selector here and your up and down here. So it's real nice. I'm not even sure how many hours are on this machine. Paul could tell me. But everything's okay. 3,446 hours we got on this thing. So AC works great. Bluetooth is working, or not Bluetooth. It's got that, but the Sirius radio's on right now. I was listening to that earlier a couple days ago. Works great. Joystick here. I'll shut this off. That's just pretty simple joystick. You got your locker button in the back for your grapple. Your grapple spin, your grapple open, close. So it's pretty simple. Put this right on the seat with you so you can bounce up and down with it. They did a lot of work on these seats. And yeah, they did a lot better job on their cat seats. They did some improvements on there. But here is your blade up and down and your winch. Forward and back, and parking brake, transmission selector deal, hydraulic fluid. If this is off, once you get off the seat, it wants to tell you there's nobody in the seat and you can't run the hydraulics. So you shut that off, then you can run the hydraulics. Your two lights and your differential locks. It's got one for the front and the rear, so you can have one locked in or both locked in. So yeah. And then here's kind of the problem a lot of people had complaints about, and it's not that great, and I see they're changing them on the new ones, is the vision out of the rear. Can't see the greatest. And what I said would be a good idea, we don't ever use windshield wipers. Rip those windshield wipers off and rip the grates off. And this has just got some chintzy plexiglass stuff in there, not really that good. And if you got some nice Lexan or something, and have some cut to fit in here, pull off all these grates and windshield wipers, that's the way to go. And I just seen Cotton Top's video the other day on that new 555, and that's exactly what they did. They took all that off, and now it's just clear. That'd help out your vision a lot in the back. But Paul runs this thing every day. He's put all the hours on this, and He's used to it. He don't care. He's not that. He's not picky. So he likes it. It runs good. No real issues. A couple issues. But as far as the rear windows inside the cab, that's about the only issues. Everything else seems to work pretty good. So quiet, runs great. We have had a couple problems with the DEF. Did a little video on that. We had problems with the DEF. It seemed to go into limp mode, and you could barely get it out of the woods. But Kat took her back, took her to their shop, got it fixed. Thanks, Troy. Troy, if you're watching this, Troy's the best mechanic in Michigan. I don't know any other mechanics anywhere else, so Troy's the best. But Troy treats us real good, and Chris Overmeyer, he treats us pretty darn good too. So Chris, if you're watching this, Troy, thanks guys. This scooter here is a beast. For as small as it is, I mean, it's not the biggest on the Cat line, but for us, it works darn good. And I'll tell you what, it's ran pretty strong for us for 3,400 hours. I know it makes a difference on our wood output. When this thing's running strong, we can put out a lot of wood. This thing will pull a lot of wood. And the operator, Paulie, he'll stay in it all day long and not complain. So, but that's a little bit on the Cat skidder we got, a little review. It works pretty good. So thanks, guys.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6 foot six and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John. Big John, Big John. Big John.